Hello everybody, hope you're doing great and are ready for some volcano updates. Today, a magnitude 3.6 earthquake struck in the Grímsvötn area, which is the largest quake in quite some time, making it somewhat unusual. The Jökulhlaup reached its peak on Sunday as expected, topping the discharge scales at 2,800 cubic meters of water per second. Our experts had to be weird and called Grímsvötn pregnant based on the most recent information. But what they mean is that an eruption could be imminent. The warning level for Grímsvötn has been raised following the large earthquake this morning, from yellow to orange. For the next couple of months, we'll be paying close attention to Grímsvötn. It's hard to say when or if an eruption will actually occur, but there's a lot pointing towards it. So let's check out the most recent data in the data and details section. So, Grímsvötn has been carrying Iceland when it comes to earthquakes since my last upload. And just this morning, at 6:16 a.m, a 3.6 magnitude earthquake struck in the Grímsvötn area. This earthquake definitely came from the Grímsvötn volcano system and was not caused by ice breaking like we've been seeing. No signs of magma movement was detected following the earthquakes, only aftershock earthquakes, so we're still waiting. The eruption could begin 2 or 3 days after the Jökulhlaup is over, or it could begin in a week or in months. We've seen all of that before, so an eruption is still pretty likely. The glacial flood, or Jökulhlaup, reached its peak on Sunday, which was predicted. The discharge was quite a bit off though, measured to be 2,800 cubic meters per second at its highest. It was around 10:30 a.m. to 13 p.m. where it was at its peak, but that is 1,200 cubic meters a second off the predicted peak of the flood. And that's just good news though. What was surprising though was just how much the ice cap descended. When I was making the last video, I had to change the value 2 times, but it was around 25 meters when I uploaded. Now it has descended 77 meters, which is 52 meters in 3 days. That's a free fall. But it looks like Grímsvötn are nearly empty, as the descent rate has decreased drastically. So now we're just waiting on what will happen next. Will Grímsvötn erupt or not? But what is going on the Reykjanes Peninsula? Well, not much to say the least. We haven't gotten any news on the situation, but something interesting happened on Saturday that caught people's attention. A huge cloud was stepping up from the crater, and our experts even had to double check if it was erupting again. It unfortunately wasn't. We don't have any more factual data on the activity here in Iceland, so we're left to speculate. Let's do that in the speculations and predictions section. On the topic of the plume, or cloud that was stepping up from the eruption, what was it? It was mostly due to weather. It was very good for something like this to happen, still and cold. We'll probably continue to see these occur for quite some time after the eruption has stopped, and this doesn't tell us much other than there's still a lot of heat and some gas being emitted from the eruption site. As always, we don't really have to speculate when it comes to Grímsvötn. We just look at past eruptions to get some idea of what to expect. And in the current situation, there is still a high chance we'll see an eruption. After all, most of the water from Grímsvötn has flown out of the chamber, which is an enormous release in pressure. But for the time being, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. I just want to thank everyone who made it here. Definitely leave any speculations and questions in the comments. It's always fun to read them. Other than that, I just hope you enjoyed. I also hope to see most of you in the next video, and thanks for watching.